Sarah Champion backstage at the Isle of Wight Festival 2017, joined by Jack Savaretti, all set to take to the main stage in the sunshine, we hope, fingers crossed.
Yeah. We're here so anything could happen. We have a pretty poor record when it comes to festivals playing in the sunshine. Oh. I've played to many an umbrellas.
You came and visited us, I think it was just after Written in Scars came out. It feels like things have blown up for you since then, certainly on paper, and you know, you're everywhere now. Obviously, it didn't happen overnight for you. I know that. Does it make you appreciate it more because it didn't happen overnight?
I don't know if it makes me appreciate it more. It makes me understand it more.
Yeah, sure.
We know why we have what we have and why we don't have what we don't have. How it is now is very much how I'd always hoped it would be.
Over the last couple of years, though, as things have kind of blown up for you, what's been your biggest kind of pinch me, is this actually happening moment, would you say?
Selling out the Hammersmith Apollo was something that... literally a year before, if you had told me we would do that, I would have thought you were a bit of a dreamer. I mean, it's definitely because we had goals to put forward to try where we wanted to go, but it was funny how long some can take, and then when certain things happen, there's a bit of a snowball effect.
You get certain things.
Playing the Royal Festival Hall as well this year was something spectacular, and I think more than anything, it's just I keep being allowed to do what I want to do, and that's as a result of being surrounded by people that we all have the same ideas, and when we actually put these ideas into action, they work out, they're working for us.
Was there a definitive moment for you? It could have been, I don't know, your first gig or seeing a particular musician where you thought, that's what I want to do with my life.
Yeah, it was the first show I ever went to. I was really lucky. My sort of high school sweetheart, when I was about 16, got me tickets to see Bob Dylan in Zurich, and he was playing at the hockey stadium, and it was half empty. And I remember walking in and first of all being shocked at how empty this sort of hockey arena was. There was just this man on stage. And I say that because to me, Bob Dylan had always been this sort of caricature that I'd seen in documentaries and on T-shirts and on posters. Mm. And it was Bob Dylan. And then I get there and it was this little guy just on stage singing songs. And I thought, that's it. He's just a guy. Like, it's very human.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's when I thought, why doesn't everybody do this? That looks like a great job.
You're on a European tour till September, is that right? Then a world tour with John Legend.
We're doing UK and Europe with John Legend.
That's a lot of time on the road. Do you get through a lot of box sets, Jack? I imagine.
I don't. The crew of the band does. I don't get. They're probably watching a box set right now. But I am a junkie to House of Cards. And I've just gotten into Stranger Things. Yes.
That's so good.
So good.
So good.
So good. And it's finally a show that me and my wife can watch together again. Because we're sort of both terrified. We sort of just sit watching the show, holding hands like little school kids. I've also gotten very into the show This Is Us.
But I can't, because something bad is going to happen to the guy. I can't deal with it. No, because it hasn't happened yet.
I've pretty much, when I say cry, I don't mean sort of sobbing, but watery shaken eyes every single episode.
I love
And I'm watching
guy.
It on the plane next to sort of, you know, adults, and I'm just sort of sitting there, and halfway through I lose it every time.
You mustn't do that. Apparently being on planes makes you more emotional.
It totally
because
does.
Because of the altitude.
So, and the fact that you're, you know, living out a miracle in a very dangerous thing at the same time.
That's true.
Your emotions, sort of, your brain doesn't register what an incredible thing you're doing.
I sobbed like I've never sobbed watching Marley and Me on a plane once, so there you go.
Haven't we all?
If I gave you absolute carte blanche to choose your dream festival lineup, and it could be people who are no longer with us, who would be your three headliners? Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Oh, Friday, I'd have to go with Half Moon Run. I'm a big Half Moon Run fan.
Good choice.
Saturday, I think the Doors would have been amazing to see. Yes. That's, I would have loved to, just for the showmanship. I'm a big fan of sort of cabaret madness, eccentricity, European circus type of stuff. So I would have loved that. And then Sunday, it would be a tie between Courtney Marie Andrews and Max Jury.
Lovely to see you. Enjoy your
set.
Thank
you for having me.
Cheers.
Have a great day. Ciao.